doing?
Really?
Let's go.
Was his home. Hurry up, Tyson.
Four miles.
All right. Thank you. 4 miles. Yeah. If it lasts for the rest of the race, the battery.
Yeah, you get about a little over an hour on that thing.
Yep.
The other Travis.
Right.
Not Travis.
Oh, you are? Okay.
and twice.
Once and twice.
Woo! She told my baby, there's a thing.
Thank you. 9.
Making their way. And as our runners continue to make their way across the line, back coming up on the 53-minute mark, we'd like to recognize that they're the sponsor of the Fox City Times. They've been the sponsor of this event for the last 41 years. The race is hosted by the City of Davenport and the Corn Belt Running Club. Our platinum sponsors include Genesis Health System, the Isle Casino and Hotel, the Premier Buick GMC dealers, the Scott County Regional Authority, and Russell Construction, the sponsor of the Break the Tape competition here. What an exciting moment that was, as both of our Break the Tape runners, Sam Olivia Moore, led the parade, followed closely by Sam Russell. So our journeyman runners here,
picking up a couple of titles here, handily beating our elites. Across the finish line now. Becky is looking good. Many time competitor here at Watch City Times 6-7.
Also want to recognize our gold medal sponsors, including Arconic, presenting sponsor of the Junior Bix, Iowa American Water, presenting sponsor of the Bix 6 training runs, Running Wild, And here comes Jen Paul. Laura Ward has been honored here with many awards over the years. I believe she has won the Brady Street Sprints at least six times, maybe more.
She's been the top
There we go.
All right, continuing to recognize our gold medal sponsors, KWQC TV. They're doing today's live broadcast. Also, thanks to Walmart and your appreciation for Walmart. Walmart for beating all of our competitors here in the race here this morning. Company, the presenting sponsor of renewable energy. And I wouldn't want to forget our contributing sponsors, which include Roto-Rooter, Wendy's, Whitey's Ice Cream. Yeah. Right.
See you next year.
Okay, my first official BIX 7 is in the books, and I did well. I exceeded my own expectations, even though I was a little bit nervous about the congestion since I was in the rear of the pack in the blue gate, which is the furthest gate from the front. Anyway, let's just cut to the chase here. I did the BIX 7 in 53 minutes and 35 seconds. I set my goal for under an hour, and I set my pace pro on my watch for 58 minutes so I would know if I was under or over pace as I went along, and it also kind of gave me some suggestions along the way of what pace to do on the hills, up and down, and stuff like that. And I always try to stay a little bit ahead, so about halfway through the race I was 2 minutes ahead of my time that I had set at 58 minutes, so I knew I was doing okay. Did take off a little bit slow at the beginning just because of the congestion, but it really didn't take very long at all to get going pretty good. Up the hill, I was probably 10 minutes a mile or less. I can't remember now, but once we got to the top of the hill, it opened up. Once we turned onto Kirkwood, opened up a lot. So, and people were running on both sides of the street for a while just to ease the congestion. And it was really, really a fun course. I loved the challenge, definitely harder on the way back than it was on the way there. Until you get to Brady Street Hill and then you go down, that's fun. But otherwise it's all kind of a long gradual uphill on the way back. But lots of music playing along the course, lots of people cheering you on, which really does help. I'll be honest, I didn't wear earbuds or anything on purpose because I wanted to hear all the sounds. And it's almost like a dream when you're running it, because I'm thinking about my pace, I'm thinking about, you know, how my running is doing, and I'm missing a lot of things, but I tried to take in as much as I could. So there's a lot of music and stuff like that, and a lot of people with different costumes and things like that on. There was a slip and slide there was lots of spray water things and all that. Anyway, 53:35, very, very happy with that. I feel good about it. This is my fastest race at this length. The only race that I've done faster than this, I think, was the Moonlight Chase, and that was only 4 miles, and that was in the evening. Not that that really matters, but that I did like at just over 7 minutes a mile, but I really pushed on that, and it was only 4 miles. So this was 7 miles, almost double that. It's actually more than a 10K by just a tiny bit. It's a 10K is 6.2 miles. This was 7 miles. So this is my longest race. That's one milestone. It was my fastest 10K. I haven't looked at Strava yet. It might not be my fastest 10K that I've done overall, but in a race, I think it is. And yeah, my first BIX. I got endorphins running all through my body right now, which just feels so good. I don't want to get hit by a car though, so I do need to pay attention to that. I'll be back.